This is Femi Kuti, and you are listening to NYC Radio Live.
All right, folks, how you doing? David Ellenbogen here, your humble servant. Today's podcast is brought to us with support from the Rubin Museum of Art, who bring us this piece of wisdom from Eddie Cantor, old comedian. He said, it takes 30 years to become an overnight success. And indeed, wow, after 30 years of making beautiful music, our featured artist today, Betsaida Machado, played the Global Fest stage Sunday night, two nights ago, and it was her New York debut, and there's a huge picture of her and a big article right in the New York Times, so maybe this is it. After 30 years, at least for us New Yorkers, us Americans, a star is born. And wow, what an incredible artist, what incredible band. We're going to hear some of her music, and we get to teach. She gets to teach us. We sit down and talk with Betsaida Machado. And just, here's this beautiful picture of the band, which is called Paranda El Clavo. And here's what the article starts off with. The singer Betsaida Machado was born in El Clavo, a village in central Venezuela that has maintained an Afro-Venezuelan Christmastime tradition called Paranda. Call and response driven songs driven by a flurry of percussion and brisk 6-against-4 rhythms. Her village group, Betsaida Machado, Paranda El Clavo, has been together 30 years. Its New York debut was a pure joy at Global Fest, the annual world music showcase that brought a dozen groups to West Webster Hall. With Miss Machado's forthright voice answered by her group's close harmonies and carried by all sorts of percussion, drums large and small, scrapers, shakers, castanets, the group performs songs about saints, dancing, slavery, and the hard lives of the cocoa plantation workers who originally sang Paranda. The costumes were brightly patterned. Dancers had light, quick steps that barely seemed to touch the stage. This was the kind of group that world music fans have always been thrilled to discover. Vital, accomplished, local, unplugged, deeply rooted. But Miss Machado's group is also using 21st century tools. It has done DNA testing to trace the musician's specific African ancestry. An Indiegogo campaign financed its American tour, and a documentary crew was capturing the scene. So, the word is out, and you'll see. I was not aware, and I look for these things. I was not aware of the Afro-Venezuelan tradition, and we learn a lot. There's some drums I had never witnessed. There's the bass drum sound is formed by it's almost like a broomstick on top of a drum that's constantly being spun, probably with some kind of wet rag, similar to like the Brazilian cuica. Like a upside down cuica kind of concept. Anyway, wow, she just destroyed. The harmonies were absolutely perfect. The dancing is amazing. The rhythms were varied and electric. So let's hear a little bit. Let's hear a track from her album Rural Recordings, Under the Mango Tree, and then we'll have a little chat with Betsaida Machado, and translated by her dedicated manager Juan Suki, who helped out with the conversation. There were a couple desperate moments when we were talking, when he had walked away, we were just chatting. And she'd say, "Oh, I think he doesn't understand." And in fact, I didn't. So yes, the Rubin Museum's Wisdom Series is underway. Thanks to them for that piece of wisdom. You can catch me there DJing the first Friday of every month. It's great to meet people who come through. All right, so let's check out this track I love from Betsaida Machado and Paranda El Clavo. It's called, it's on their album Rural Recordings Under the Mango Tree. And this is called Mimeo Juliana. And then we will get talking with Betsaida Machado. All right, thanks for listening. Put your seatbelt on for this one. All right, ciao. Concierto es la mejor cosa en la entero cosa. Claro.
Muchas gracias.
Sí. Perhaps she could tell us a little short history of the this music, where it comes from.
Le comentaba a varios que me preguntan que qué es la parranda, ¿no?
Many people ask me what is parranda, what is la parranda.
En Venezuela, parranda significa muchas personas de una región que se van de fiesta, de farra.
In Venezuela, parranda means when a big group of people from a specific region just go out together to party.
El pueblo donde yo me crié, donde están mis padres, mis madres, donde nos criamos todos los que estamos acá en la parranda, tenemos como que de costumbre todos los principios y finales de año sacar una parranda que ya tiene más de 30 años.
For more than 30 years, the town where I come from, my family, friends and I, we have the tradition of taking the parranda out every year for more than 30 years.
Nuestro fuerte como repertorio, por supuesto, es la parranda del pueblo nuestro, del Clavo, y quisimos traerle al escenario un poco de lo que complementa el calendario en Venezuela a nivel de folclore.
So we are our strength, or where we do the most, of course, are the actual parrandas from El Clavo. And now that we're touring, we are mixing some of these parrandas with various other specific, very valuable genres of Venezuelan traditions.
El repertorio, como lo acabo de decir, bueno, la parranda, por ser la parte que nosotros más desarrollamos, el fuerte que tenemos, pero hay un calendario que va caminando, que habla de velorio de Cruz de Mayo. En Miranda, la zona de donde venimos, se le canta la Cruz de Mayo, se hacen folías, se hace una serie de cantos en Navidad, y de hecho hoy del estado, de otros estados, y hoy dentro del repertorio que hay parranda, sangueo o cantos lentos y otros más fuertes, y aparte de eso, bueno, la parranda, yo creo que no me está entendiendo mucho, pero está muy unido a lo que es culminación de año o principio de año, y que va como que se extiende durante todo el año.
Okay, espera. So there, when you dive into Venezuelan folklore, you discover that there is a calendar of very specific traditions and parties that are related to music, to specific music. So there are parties or events like the Cross of May, and the folías, and then there are some very specific Christmas traditional songs. Part of what we perform today are some of those genres.
Que la parranda está muy es como que si se solo en Navidad, y no es solamente en Navidad. O sea, el venezolano se caracteriza por ser muy parrandero durante todo el año.
Some people get confused with parranda and they think parranda is Christmas or end of the year specific, but out of the partying nature of Venezuelans, parranda is a year-long activity.
Se extiende durante todo el año. Y un poco de lo que estuve haciendo en el repertorio de hoy, hay cantos a capela, sin ninguna instrumentación, se requiere cantos de sirena o cantos de faena, que se une como a todo este género, y bueno, y es un poco para armar un repertorio tomando de todo un poco, para que la gente disfrute de lo poco que podemos traer al escenario, porque son muchos géneros, son muchas cosas, pero realmente no es fácil tampoco traerlo al escenario por cuestiones de instrumentación y lo más sencillo que podemos presentarlo, lo más natural. Aquí no tenemos instrumentos de cuerda, aquí no tenemos, o sea, el bajo que tenemos en la parranda es un furro. Yo me imagino que él nos vio, ¿no? No tenemos realmente algo melódico, o sea, es simplemente que estamos tan acostumbrados a trabajar juntos que la tonalidad y todo la tenemos ya como que pensada.
so it's a long segment, but I'll try to do my best. So you're seeing the parranda at its raw. We didn't bring any melodic instruments, or our bass is that furro, which is some kind of talking drum. So what you see us doing is the result of doing it for so long that even the tones, we don't have like a melodic instrument that would give us a note. We just know the notes of the songs. We just sing them by heart. And then the folkloric tradition is so extensive, and there are so many drums and genres that although we used a lot, and if you see in detail, you see that we have some a cappella stuff like the siren chants that are a cappella singing, and other genres that we do in the show. It would be impossible to do them all because there are many different drums and many different styles.
Pelar, por lo mucho que tú quieras, que en la casa no hay sala, hoy está vacía la nevera. Por lo mucho que tú quieras, no la vayas a pelar, que en la casa no hay sala, hoy está vacía la nevera.
No la peles, papá, que en la casa no hay sala, estaba la mujer y tú y yo emocionado. No la peles, papá, que en la casa no hay sala, estaba la mujer y tú y yo emocionado.
Ay, por lo mucho que tú quieras, no la peles, papá.
No tiene loco, no consigo, gran marrón, ni salado tampoco.
So, if I understand correctly, this music is for festivals, research, parties. Pero es muy similar a música para ceremonias en otro país. Música de Cuba por Orisha, pero no. In Venezuela, solamente there's no this. Is there ceremonial religious music that sounds like this in Venezuela?
Sí. Nosotros en Venezuela tenemos un santo que si se requiere católico.
In Venezuela, we have one Catholic. You could say Catholic saint.
Sí, San Juan Bautista, el Bautista de Cristo, y es uno de los santos más festejados en Venezuela. Es el que más se celebra. Y precisamente la parranda que tiene la unión con la Navidad, el nacimiento del Niño Dios, final de la Navidad. Cruz de Mayo, o sea, nuestro calendario va como que muy, si se requiere, de la parte católica, si se requiere.
The calendar that we go by, it's actually very Catholic. It is the festivities that is linked to our Catholic festivities. And then San Juan, San John the Baptist, is a Catholic saint. I have some stuff to tell you about that is not in her answer. I'll tell you about it later. But it's the reason why you le voy a decir un poco de por qué le suena similar la de Cuba. The reason why you find the similarity with the Cuban music is because they're both African. They're both the result of the African tradition. So Cuba is maybe more related to Ifá, which is the roots of the also African religion. In Venezuela, the syncretism of African traditions with Catholicism was stronger. So, although they keep the rhythms and they keep the party and they keep the sound, not necessarily the relationship to the culture of Ifá or any other African culture is the same.
Okay, my last question is, I would love to learn maybe the names of some of the different rhythms that we hear here, and also maybe if she could tell us a little bit about one track, and then we'll listen to the track. Yeah. Pero primero la rima, por favor.
¿Cómo dice?
Los géneros de las canciones.
Claro. Claro. Ay, que me veo, ay, que me veo. Esta la número 6.
¿Sí?
La número 6. Él estuvo en la presentación nuestra hoy.
Sí, que si tú, if you were in the show today.
Okay. Los tambores largos que se meten dentro de la pierna.
Between their legs.
Yeah.
Se llaman culuepuya.
They're called culuepuya.
Mm-hmm. O tambor redondo.
Or round drum.
Nosotros hoy cantamos una que se llama mayoral.
We sang one today that's called mayoral.
Mayoral habla de los tiempos de la esclavitud.
Talks about slaves.
Esta es una batería de tres tambores: prima, cruzado, pujado, y esto son tres ejecutantes, tres músicos. ¿Sí me está entendiendo?
This is specifically a battery of three drums. Called prima, pujao, and cruzao, and it's an ensemble of three musicians, of three players.
Sí. Necesita de tres ejecutantes. Muy, son tonadas que se bailan.
It's dance and tones or songs that are danced, that are meant to be danced.
Y casi son muy para San Juan Bautista, en una zona en Barlovento, que sobre todo Curiepe, que es donde se celebra San Juan Bautista, es bien festejado, y esto es uno de los géneros que se hace para San Juan: tambor redondo o culuepuya.
They're mainly based, like the culuepuyas are the strongest place. They're from, it's from Curiepe, because it's the place where these parties are most celebrated.
Una batería de tres.
No, ya, eso.
Okay, digo, sí. Okay.
Que eran de Curiepe, que esa es la zona donde se celebra más la festividad de San Juan.
Sí, es como la zona más reconocida.
It's the most recognized or representative zone where the San Juan parties are celebrated in the area of Barlovento.
Y la pareja que baila va haciendo los gestos de lo que dice el cantante.
And the way song and dance work is that the dancers are supposed to do what the singer is asking them to do.
Ajá. Tambor redondo.
Round drum.
Porque la pareja baila en círculo.
Because the couple dances in circles. Ah,
okay. Redondo. Culuepuya. Es porque el tambor está como que por dentro, para su sonoridad, está acabado como un reloj de arena.
So, culuepuya actually means pointy ass. Yes. So the reason why it's called pointy ass is that if you see how the drum is made, they actually build their drums. So, or those at least. So if you see how the drum is made inside, it's like a sand clock, so it would have like a pointy ass in inside. Yeah.
Y por eso se les llama culuepuya.
That's how why they're called pointy ass.
Culuepuya. Well, on that note, gracias por su tiempo. Es una. It would be great if we heard. Is there anything that she thinks people misunderstand about her music that we should know?
Pienso que quizás el hacer tantos géneros y la similitud que tiene, por ejemplo, con Cuba, con es porque definitivamente tenemos esta mezcla de África, ¿no? Pero realmente pienso que lo que les hace es animar por el ritmo que lleva, y no nos disgusta nada. Aquí casi todo lo que encierra este género es parranda, todo. Y la única que tienes aquí, la número 6, que es otro género, pero que es de Venezuela, y casi todos nuestros ritmos, algunos se le asemeja a la música, no sé, hasta de Puerto Rico, alguna, por el clarín o la paila, pero la ejecución definitivamente habría que vivirla, pues habría que verla para que puedas entender un poco más de lo que tenemos.
So sometimes the music is like easily compared to the sounds of Cuba or Puerto Rico, because both the Afro tradition that the countries share, and also some specific drums that are very similar in these countries. So sometimes it's taken as like dance Latin music, period, and it's complex for someone who is not close to the genres to understand the difference between ones and the other. So, for example, in this album you have most of it is parranda, and then you have the culuepuya. So it's for someone who doesn't really know the genres and the differences, it's maybe like it could be just like, yeah, like party music or like festive music. Yeah.
En ritmo. Con el recorrido que entramos.
How we entered the room today, like as a procession or like a you say procession in English, yeah, like a procession.
Procesión, ajá, exactamente. Se le llama sanga.
That's called sanga.
O sangueo.
or sangueo.
Porque es lento.
Because it's slow.
Y es con lo que se pasea a San Juan Bautista en la
costa. That's how you walk the saint around in the coast.
The saint.
You make a procession.
Procesión al santo.
So you take him out.
Y entonces es como que ese ritmo pa tun tu cum pa tun tu cum pa tun tu cum. Si se requiere es como parecido a un paso puertorriqueño, o sea que tiende como que eso exactamente, pero fíjate, los tambores son totalmente diferentes y la ejecución es diferente, pues. Similitud por la familiaridad de los caribes, del latino. Pero a pesar de que somos de una zona de Barlovento, que quizás mucha gente no conoce los ritmos, pero fíjate, o sea, a la gente le llama la atención, bien sea auditivamente o visualmente, ¿no?
Claro. ¿Qué es la ritmo, el nombre de la ritmo en eso?
Pueblo de fiesta, este habla exactamente de como del recorrido con lo que entramos hoy. Hoy mi pueblo está de fiesta, se tiene ta tirara, y todo el mundo cantando al ritmo de esta canción. Habla un poco de y es como el ritmo de sanga, de sangueo.
Sanga.
Lento. Significa lento.
Sí, sí, sí.
Lento. Y nosotros lo llamamos sangueo.
Okay, claro. Ok. Gracias por su tiempo.
Muchas gracias.
Muy buen dancer.
¿Cómo está?
Mi pueblo está de fiesta, se siente grande.